Hey everybody, I am Brett Ehrlich, host of Infomania's Viral Video Film School, right here on Current TV. It is my job to comb the depths of YouTube and Break.com and all those webbing sites and teach you filmmaking, if not life lessons along the way. We're looking back on my favorite lessons, and they all center this half hour around showing off, which is a proud tradition online. And looking at this list, these are some of my very favorite episodes. We got the talent show, we got dorm rooms, weapons, tattoos, and this one. A lot of people have asked me, are you stoned or drunk when you're making these lessons? And the answer is, not. And while I've never been stoned, I was at home having a few drinks during this next segment, and you might see a Bloody Mary, a 3 a.m. Bloody Mary, show its head for a second in this, the After Effects lesson. Okay, so After Effects. Remember those kids who used to put tin foil on their head so they could look like space commanders? After Effects is the product of those people growing up and becoming computer programmers. The tools they've programmed into After Effects give you great power. But with great power comes great responsibility. Not to embarrass yourself. Dig the puppet tool. Take a still picture and make it move around. But don't do what this guy did. What are you having me watch? Zombie plus Gumby equals Zumbi? More like zombie plus Gumby equals Dumby. The derivative of which is boring bee. That's word math. How about bumblebee? It's calc. It's word calc. Do what this kid did. Give me story. Yeah, kicky foot dance. Then we've got other characters, like number 7 here, who has 3 hands. 2 play the fiddle, and 1 beats the crap out of his hip. Conflict and resolution happen pretty quick. Hey, shot his face off. Slow-mo, sprinkle blood. It's not real, so it's okay. Another cool tool is when people distort their faces so they look like demons. Just be sure of one thing. Make sure you don't look like a demon when you're not using the special effect. Now that's terrifying. Yeah. Also, thanks for taking your shirt off to do that. I really appreciate it. But the final effect that I love is the Kamehameha effect from Dragon Ball Z, or as it's pronounced by people who can read, Dragon Balls. Basically, you throw a fake energy ball. Man, his fake neighbors must be pissed. My advice here is cast carefully. Specifically, don't cast yourself. It looks like this. Yes, people might forward this along, but you honestly think people are gonna forward this to their friends saying, look how cool this guy is? Beware the fate of geeks on tape. Basically, you just don't want to be this guy. Sure, he's nice, but it can't be easy for him. The way to go with this kind of video is cast your little brother or anybody under the age of 12. And you can make him the coolest kid in the 4th grade. Explosion-y kids. That kid's gonna love his big bro forever. Thank you for your time. Sincerely, Viral Video Film School. Man, I love that episode. Alright, this next one that we're moving on to is people showing off something else. Not what they've made on the computer, but what they've made someone draw on their body. This is a Viral Video Film School about tattoos, and at the end, I call out for people, if they want to get a Viral Video Film School tattoo, they should contact me. I'm currently in the process of setting up those visits. That promise still holds true today, as it will through the end of time, so contact me on Facebook or Twitter and I will go with you as you get, I'm not, that would be stupid, as you get a Viral Video Film School tattoo. Talking Mom's not the only person with a tattoo video. Everyone has a tattoo video. You should too. First, select a design. Guys, you should get a word in a font with loads of serifs. Ladies, you will get something that communicates your unique personality, and it will be a butterfly. Butterfly, butterfly, butterflies everywhere. It's always a butterfly, and it never looks like a butterfly, ladies. It always looks like a moth, and that's not cute, that's gross. This woman chose a non-butterfly, but something equally puzzling.
It's a lotus flower?
Yeah, that definitely looks like a lotus flower.
Brett, you said you needed an artichoke?
Oh, thanks. But just be sure you like what you get, because that will be with you forever. This woman chose something interesting. It's the word pubes on her lip.
Does she get little pubes coming out of her gums?
Yeah, that'd be ridiculous. I wanted the word pubes on my lip. Flash forward 5 years later. Mommy, what does that say on your mouth? Sweetie, that says regret. Regret is tricky because you will have this forever. You don't want to end up like this, Irish gent.
The only regret I ever had about my tattoos is this one tattoo. It's a dragon, a blue dragon, and he's like standing on or clinging to a medallion that has a Celtic kind of design.
Right, I mean, it does look like a blue blob, but that's, I think, what dragons look like. Never seen a dragon, but the man who gave me this said that dragons look like blue blobs. No, you want to be proud of that tattoo. You want to get out there and sing it to the entire internet, maybe.
This is a couple bars of a Stevie Wonder song. I'm not going to sing it for you.
She can sing, so she really could sing it.
I can't sing, but I'm very shy.
Oh yeah, she seems shy, showing me her entire upper pelvic area. That's what shy girls do. This guy doesn't have any performance anxiety. He wrote a rap poem about his tattoo that he says he wrote ahead of time, but I'm not so sure.
The crocodile skins means my strength, and I rock throughout the nation. The basket weaving is my foundation. And now, you know, it's so normal.
Might wanna do another draft there, just saying. And that's it. Oh, one more thing. You should make the video after you've gotten the tattoo. Cause tattoos are supposed to prove you're tough. So I'd advise against making a video that proves that you cried like a baby the whole time. That reminds me of me when I got this tattoo of me showing people my tattoo. It took forever. It's an infinity image. No, literally, it took forever. Now you're ready. Go get your tattoo. And I'm not saying you have to, but if you want to get a Viral Video Film School tattoo, send me an email. I'll go with you. Join us on the next Viral Video Film School. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, this woman doing, I think she's a woman. That's definitely a Rubik's Cube. And now, a Viral Video Film School pop quiz. Question one, what happens when you don't actually throw the hammer in the hammer throw? Answer this. I didn't get the shot. I expected you to throw the hammer. That's why they call it hammer throw, not moron tumble. Either way, job well done. And that was your Viral Video Film School pop quiz. That wasn't such a chore now, was it? Hey everybody, welcome back to this half hour special edition of Viral Video Film School, where we are looking at my favorite lessons about showing off the proud tradition on the internet. And this is not only one of my favorite lessons, but it's also the one that gave birth to wall things. These guys that people send in all the time. So, enjoy. Anything that was on my wall before that was either put up for the theme of the lesson I was doing, or I just picked it out because it was cool. Anyways, here's some talent shows. Oh, Hello, everyone. Before we start class today, I wanted to say I got a new office and therefore a new wall. I already have a hearth, but I need things to put on my wall. So either put them in the comments or email me at brett@thenthisshouldsaycurrent.com. But it doesn't because I ran out of black tape. All right, American Idol is back. Aren't you excited? Pretty soon we'll have another name to add to the list of people that show's made famous, like Kelly or Ruben, Fantasia, Theo, Mallory, Blanche. Doesn't matter who I say, you wouldn't remember them anyway. What is this, like season 30? Well, you know what? I'm not watching this season because I can see all the talent I want on the internet. And for today's class, we're gonna take time to appreciate the glorious, wide, albeit shallow, talent pool that is online. You want singing? You'll get singing.
Back when we were young.
Only online, you get a little something more.
Never.
That woman is going places after she writhes around on the floor for a while. People on television talent shows may be accompanied by real bands, but only online would someone play an instrument like this.
Broccoli ocarina.
Who said you couldn't play with your food? Oh, sh**.
Big size.
Some talents out there are talents you didn't even know could exist until you see them with your own eyes. Like this one, where a 1980s Muscle Beach type woman solves a Rubik's Cube while surrounded by tribal drums. Wait, maybe that isn't a woman. Is that the Gladiator Malibu? Here's another talent you wouldn't appreciate were it not for online video. Now, what's the talent here? Not that he can play beer pong, but that he has the patience to lock himself in a garage until he makes the f***ing shot. But what happens to the beer cups after they've been ponged? The perpetual talent show that is the internet lets no resource go to waste. You try it. If you think American Idol showcases the most amazing, astonishing performances available, well, then you clearly haven't met Fast Clap Guy.
Hello, I'm Kent French, but you can call me Toast.
I'm sorry, Toast. Talented not only at clapping, but at making these faces while he does it. That doesn't look that hard. Take that, American Idol. And you know what? For all you talented people out there on the internet, you practice hard with your absolutely random talents. Because you never know when you're gonna get that chance on national television, and you don't wanna end up like this guy. You only get one shot to shine on the former Soviet bloc watermelon head-breaking game show circuit. Don't blow it. Join us next time on Viral Video Film School. Hey everyone, don't go anywhere. When we come back, we're gonna go into all these college dorm rooms and not get arrested for it. Hopefully. And now, a Viral Video Film School pop quiz. What is the national anthem of hell? Answer, this is my favorite clip all week, I'll say it. If you haven't seen this Soviet era crooner, just bask in his glory. It's amazing. Now we know where Conan O'Brien got his hairstyle. And that was your Viral Video Film School pop quiz. Who said wasting time never got you anything? Hey everybody, welcome back to this special edition of Viral Video Film School. It is a half hour special. I am Brett Ehrlich, and I'm taking you through my favorite lessons over the years about showing off. And this is showing off something that's a very important part of everyone's life. It's a place where they will create a lot of memories and then do a lot of things they won't remember later. It is the dorm room. Most lessons I make so I can show funny videos. This one I made just so I could tell jokes about college. The The summer is over, and now, all over the country, 18-year-old hormone balls are headed off to that big, giant, drunken orgy near the IKEA known as college. So show us your room!
Okay, here's our dorm room.
Oh yeah, this is pretty much my room, by the way.
Here is my dorm.
Welcome to my crib.
Everyone makes a dorm tour video, and you know why? Typically you do it for your long-distance high school sweetheart, so they'll be able to concretely visualize the place you cheat on them. This girl offers some alternate explanations.
This is partly gonna be for my own documentation, and partly for whoever else wants to see it.
Just as close friends.
Hey.
Take care with these videos. You want to be meticulous about showing total strangers where you sleep and keep all your cool stuff.
Oh yeah, here's my Wii, and I've got a single and therefore no friends to ward off thieves.
But you know what? You're probably safe. It's not like anyone shows their address or anything. Oh god, I was wrong about that. Hey, you know what? This isn't just your room. You've got roommates. So include them. Even if it's the guy who won't stop playing guitar even though you're shooting a video and playing music over that.
This is where we like to hang out and chill as a group.
By month two, it's more like, yes, I know you know how to play Hey There, Delilah. I don't need to hear it every 5 minutes. Here's an idea. Show people you're funky. Like you just went crazy and painted a wall. Just one wall. Purple. And posters. College is a great opportunity to express yourself through posters of things you didn't know you liked until they were one of six options at the student store. Don't forget picture collages. These will start out as pictures of friends from high school, but slowly, they'll become friends from college. And this'll weird you out a little bit, but don't worry about it. They're freshman year friends. Those disappear. Be sure to tell us about things we might not be able to identify.
So this is like the door.
Chair. Table.
Closets. Stepladder. Tangle of wires.
Here's my fridge. Stuff on top of the fridge.
That stuff on top of the fridge? You college kids are so smart. Another thing you might want to include is what you're eating.
This is ramen noodles, and this is what I'm going to eat tomorrow night. Because the cafeteria doesn't serve food on Sunday nights. So that'll be interesting. I'll have to see what that tastes like.
What's your major?
I'm majoring in digital writing.
Might want to rethink pre-law, or that ramen will taste like the next 15 years of your life. And finally, here's some philosophy. Your dorm room is a blank canvas, which you think you're customizing with your Target bought knickknacks and your Urban Outfitter baubles. But these purchases are only the beginning. What really makes this room your dorm room is the stories. Cause right now, that's the same refrigerator everybody has. But soon it will be the fridge that Brad sleepwalks to every night and pees in. And right now, that's just a simple lampshade. But soon it will be the key part of your Halloween costume when you decide to go as a slutty lampshade. And right now, this is just a John Lennon poster. But soon it will be an excuse to get a girl to come back to your room and look at a poster so you could have sex with her. Because come on, she's slutty lampshade. Work hard, play hard. Join us on the next Viral Video Film School. Don't go anywhere. When we come back, we got people making weapons out of nothing and doing very little damage with them. Welcome back. We're almost done with our Showing Off Viral Video Film School special. If you look over my shoulder in this next session, you will see this guy who sent my favorite bit of fan mail ever. The subject, you were one funny f***er. I have dial-up, so YouTube and other such sites are off-limits to me. So you give me loads of entertainment on viral film whatever. Let's see if I can send a pic of me cleaning the mold off my double-wide. Gonna take a friggin' hour to send. Dial-up blows. Amazing, just like the people in this next segment about crappy weapons. Okay, today we are talking about the best kind of weapon video. And I'm not talking about videos of people shooting guns, because that plan often backfires. I'm talking about better, more democratic, dumber videos, where you make your weapon yourself. Check out this weapon of little or no destruction. It's called the Penny Shooter.
I'm gonna test how many of these bottles I can hit from about 6 feet away.
Yeah! Direct hit! You will lay waste to anything that is as heavy as or lighter than an empty plastic bottle. This guy shows you how to make all different kinds of slingshots with various types of rubbers. For instance, rubbers.
So we now attached 4 condoms per side.
looks quite disgusting. I hope it's functional. So now we have attached both sides, and now we have a functional slingshot.
And he just nails stuff with it. Ow! Now condoms can kill more than just the joy of sex. And now, naming your weapons with Vague Monotone Boy. I love this kid. What's this one called?
Here's my scary... scary thing.
You have a scary, scary thing? Ah, because I already have a frightening, stabber. Got anything else?
My... blade... glove... thing.
Ah, yes, the blade glove thing! From his brand new line of stabby hand whatevers! Finally, this guy is my favorite of the week. He's improvised weapon sensei, Professor Ronald Duncan. He'll teach you how to make a weapon out of anything, even a rolled up magazine.
The rolled up magazine is utilized is what we term the blunt edge. It can be used for striking, thrusting.
Here's what it looks like in action against a man with an interesting haircut.
You want this chair? Yeah, I want the chair. Get away from me!
Conflict resolved. Almost.
Stop it! Take your chair. No, never do that again.
And that's it. So get out there and make your own weapons of mass dysfunction. Because otherwise, you're just fighting with your hands, which either don't work at all. Or work a little too well.
Are you going trick-or-treating?
No, probably.
That guy deserved it. Join us on the next Viral Video Film School. Wall things. If you don't see your wall thing, it's probably in this stack. That's it, everyone. I'd like to thank you for joining us. If you like what you saw, you can always watch more on Infomania right here on Current TV. Or you can go to current.com/Infomania or youtube.com/viralvideos to see more. That's all I got. I'd like to see some clips over credits. Right, I mean, it does look like a blue blob. Yeah, kicky foot dance. That stuff on top of the fridge? You college kids are so smart. Man, his fake neighbors must be pissed. And it will be a butterfly. Butterfly, butterfly, butterflies everywhere. Who said you couldn't play with your food? Oh, shit. Now condoms can kill more than just the joy of sex. Because come on, she's slutty lampshade. Work hard, play hard.
Watch Infomania's half-hour show every Thursday night at 10 p.m. on Current TV.